Hello and welcome to Let's Watch Leibowitz Play Dungeon Crawl Stone Soup. This time I'm gonna play a merfolk gladiator. I like merfolk because they can swim, they can cross water easily, and that comes in handy quite sometimes. I hope I'm gonna survive long enough for you to see that, actually. I don't wanna use a shield because the attack with the trident is a lot better without a shield. I'm gonna turn off some of those. Yeah, that should do it. So, if scrolls here already, an amulet of rage, not bad. As you probably have guessed already, I'm the little at sign in the middle of the game screen, and those other letters are my enemies. At the moment, they're not too dangerous. Rats and goblins and occasional hobgoblin, maybe. So nothing to really be scared of. Well, I say that a lot. Nothing to be scared of. But I still sometimes die in those early levels. But mostly I survive now because I got pretty good at this game, even if I say so myself. Okay, let's try out my javelins. Javelin of penetration. Yeah, why not? Javelins are actually not bad, they do a lot of damage. Penetration means they'll pass through one enemy and hit one or more other enemies standing behind that one. So not really good against one opponent, but can come real handy if you're fighting more opponents at once. Ah, plate mail. That would be nice if I were a warrior. I'm not really. I don't rely on wearing thick armor. I actually survive by dodging, which is a lot easier by wearing light armor than heavy armor. So, level 1 done. Let's go down. What is this? Another amulet. I stay with the amulet of rage for now. Probably wait until I have scroll of identify before wearing that one. An angel. And Zin. Altar of Sin. No, I don't want to worship Sin. Too boring. Money. A rune rope. That looks interesting. Plus 2. So I can drop that one. I found pretty good armor already. Plus 2 boots and plus 2 rope. That is a nice start, actually. I'm happy with that. Okay, now I'm hungry for the first time. What was that? Miasma emanates from the human's flesh. What the hell is going on? Maybe I should start pay some attention. So there's an altar of Kikubakutga, or however he is pronounced. God of necromancers. I don't plan on going in that direction, though. I'll pass him by as well. Meh. Needles of sleeping. Yeah, why not? I'll take those. Could come in handy. Alright, I reached level 3. Let's go with strengths. I'll try to bring strengths up to 20 before I raise another one of my attributes. Eat some chai newt. Merfolk don't really like raw flesh, but if they're hungry, they'll eat it. So that's more like emergency food than anything else. But as long as I don't, well, as long as I have enough of that, I don't need to eat any of my food that keeps. Which is good. Okay. Come on, man. Good. We're not really doing too much damage, I fear. Some of those monsters take a lot of hits before they go down. I don't appreciate that. But not those monsters, because they're really, really basic enemies. And I've reached level 4. I like that. With each level, as you can see, my health and magic goes up a little bit, and every, I don't know, 4 or 5 levels, one of my attributes goes up. So leveling up is helpful, which is not a big surprise, or it shouldn't be a big surprise. Plus one hat, well, it's better than nothing, that is for sure, but not by far. Okay. Don't really want a quarterstaff. Fed has. See, that's nice to be merfolk now, because I can cross this deep water and other characters couldn't. What is this Fedas? Oh, Blossoming, he's the god of plants. No, I don't want you either. Hopefully I'll get some more useful altars in the near future. Okay. Oh. Uncool, uncool, actually. So run away. Find a bottleneck. This works. Good. Gnolls and hounds. Gnolls will give nice experience, and I've reached level 5 and became a bit stronger. Nice. Okay. Um Nothing really interesting. Let's finish those off. And I'm pretty sure my time's almost up, so I'll finish for now. Thanks for watching, and hopefully see you next time.